Hi there, Christopher Harrison, Senior Program Manager, Microsoft. Let's take a look at how we can utilize async await to manage our asynchronous calls inside of JavaScript. Now, one big thing to keep in mind about async await is the fact that these are, or this is, built on top of promises. And so as a result, we're going to start with the little helper function that we had from before, that promise timeout, that converts a promise into async await, which, by the way, means that any time at all that you're calling a function that's going to give you back a promise, you can use the async await syntax. Now, async await starts with an asynchronous function. So I'm going to say async function, and we'll give this name of run in my case. And then now I'm going to go ahead and put in my logic here. Now, one big thing to keep in mind about the way that JavaScript works is I'm not able to use await unless I'm inside of an asynchronous function. As such, what I need to do is I need to create that function and then go ahead and call it there, that I'm not allowed to just simply say await and then promise timeout. That unfortunately, that syntax is not gonna work here. All right, now, the way that await is going to work is it's going to logically block execution, if you will, but still actually allow the thread to be used by something else behind the scenes. So while our code running, if you will, is going to look like it's stopping, behind the scenes, it's actually still able to do other things if that's what needs to happen. So I'm going to say await, and then let's say promise timeout, and let's say 1,000. Actually, I'm going to do 2,000. There we go. And I'm going to just say, say right up here, console log, whoops, log start, and then console.log, and then stop. Okay, cool. So now when I run this, what's going to happen is it's going to print out that start, the pause, and then stop. So even though it looks like all three of these lines of code are just boom, 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 you're going to notice that it's going to pause and wait for the execution to take place. Again, it's just pausing here. Behind the scenes, other things could potentially be happening. Now, one of the big things about JavaScript, and there are certain tools that can help you catch things like this, is it's possible for me to call a function that's going to return a promise without putting in an await. And when I do that, you notice that I get different behavior here. Let me go ahead and just add in a real quick console.log. No, that's not really going to behave the way that I want it to. That's all right. So let me rerun this, and let's you know, sort of keep an eye on what's happening. That what you're going to notice is I've got my start here, I've got my stop there. Now, when I had the await right there, let me make sure I save this, and I ran this, you'll notice start and then stop. Without this await, what you're going to notice, big change here, is the fact that it's going to go start, stop, then the pause afterwards. And the reason is because I didn't pause the execution, if you will. I did not put in that await right here, which is going to be required. So if you're ever getting unusual behavior, or you're getting error messages about you know, an expected return value not being what you expected it to be, quite frequently it's because you missed an await. So keep that in mind. Whenever you're working with promises, always, always, always make sure if you're using async await to use that await. And so as another example here, let me go ahead and say async function long running operation. So let's just pretend, if you will, that that was going to go call a server or do something long running. So it would, you know, my logic here. In our case, I'm just simply going to say return and then 42. Now I can go grab that value by saying const response equals await and then that long running operation. And then if I say console log and then the response, what you'll notice is that it's going to print out the number 42. And the reason for that is because it's going to go run that, wait for the promise to complete, which will have happened instantaneously because we just returned the number 42, and then give me access to that value. If we don't do that, if we don't have that await, note the difference here. Note the difference in the output. Let me just put in a couple of returns here. So if I rerun this, now what you're going to notice down here is that I'm going to get start. Oops, let's make sure I save this. There we go. Try this one more time. Okay. So let me run this one more time. Start. And then you'll notice that it's going to give me back this promise 42. And the reason that it's doing that is because I don't have that await. The reason that it worked that first time was just because I hadn't saved the file, so the await was still there. So if you're ever seeing that behavior, it's going to be because you forgot to put in await. Now, what I really like about using async await is that this feels more natural to me than using then for managing our promises. And you're also going to notice that really going forward, this is going to continue to become more common, not only just inside of JavaScript, but also in other programming languages. And so that is how we can utilize async await for managing promises inside of JavaScript.